And for those of you that are looking at the screen right now, when we talk about never place a paper paycheck, that is absolutely the goal of adding a pay card like Rapid Pay Card to your benefit offering to your employees. We would like for all of you to be able to get to 100% direct deposit, and that's what we're going to explain today, how you might be able to get there and how you can get there at no cost to your company. First off, let's talk about why you might need it and the problem that we face as employers in the United States, and very much the underserved segment could be the cause of your inability to get to 100% direct deposit. There are 821,000 more U.S. households that have become unbanked since the first FDIC survey in 2009. This was just updated this year by the Philadelphia FDIC, and it represents a 0.6% increase in the number of unbanked individuals. There are 8.2% of U.S. households are unbanked, with approximately 17 million adults in unbanked households. 20.1% of U.S. households are underbanked. This represents one out of every five households, or 24 million households with 51 million adults. That's a large number, and many of those individuals oftentimes pass through your particular vertical of staffing at one time or another. 29.3% of households do not have a savings account, while 10% do not have a checking account. So how in the world are you supposed to get them onto direct deposit without offering them another alternative that doesn't put them at risk? And 25% of those households have used at least one alternative financial service, such as non-banked check cashing or payday loans in the past year. Almost 1 in 10 households have used two or more types of alternative financial services in that period of time. That is also the definition of unbanked or underbanked as we go forward. In all, 12% of households have used an alternative financial solution in the past 30 days, including 4 in 10 unbanked or underbanked households. I would tell you that within staffing, that percentage is significantly higher because you deal with many transient employees and also many individuals that may be walking through the process of using alternative financial services and may fall into the unbanked. So next, we'd like to make the case for prepaid. And in making the case for prepaid, we're going to turn it over to Dallas, so that he can talk a bit about the problems that you all in staffing faced and some problems that he experienced personally, and he'll relate them to some of his history. So, Dallas, over to you.
Great, great. I appreciate it, Brian. As many on this call, I'm sure will agree, in the staffing industry, we have a lot of challenges that are unique to the industry. But in looking at the challenges that we face with our payroll, and speaking from experience from where I was at before, my previous employers, you know, we had a couple of different employees, as I mentioned before. We had local offices that were, you know, around the country. In fact, one of the companies I worked with, we had close to 100 offices around the U.S. And we had employees that were working on commercial construction job sites in each of those local markets. We also had employees that were working on the road. We called them travelers. With our local employees, our challenge with check distribution, what really came into play when it with getting the checks to our employees, and what our method of doing so was to have somebody each week that would stay behind at our local offices and would be there for the employees so that they could come in after their shifts on Friday, which was payday, and pick up their paychecks. It was a great idea, but unfortunately, what we found was that we had a lot of employees that were actually leaving early each day, coming into the offices to pick up those checks, as opposed to coming in at the end of the day after their shift. Some employees were coming in a couple hours early. Unfortunately, a lot of our employees were coming in at lunchtime and sometimes even at their first break in the morning. You know, one of the things that I think a lot of us share in the staffing industry is that we have a lot of employees that are working on a paycheck-to-paycheck basis. So throughout the week, and certainly the first thing they think of Friday morning or payday when they get up, is picking up that paycheck and taking care of their obligations. So in addition to them coming into the office and picking up their paychecks, which was already bad enough when they were leaving early, we had employees that were coming in, getting those checks, and then proceeding to go to the bank or a check cashing facility to stand in line, get their funds, and then oftentimes continuing on instead of going back to work to pick up money orders at the closest 7-Eleven or U.S. Postal Office, and then going further and driving around town to pay their bills. Obviously, this was very time-consuming. Obviously, it hurt the employees when it came to their compensation because they weren't on the job sites, they weren't collecting hours, so they were losing pay. It was also very expensive for them, Brian, to cash their checks. When employees were fortunate enough to have have an office from the bank that we drew our checks against in their local market, again, we are spread out across the United States, those employees did have the option to go into that local bank to cash their check, but they were still paying, you know, I would say at least $5, and in some places in the Northeast, possibly $8 or $9 to do so. But many of the employees who didn't have that option or employees who were looking for convenience would, I think, most of the time go to a check cashing facility where they were paying upwards of 10% to cash their check. And when we talk about employees that are oftentimes living paycheck to paycheck, that is quite a bit of their take-home pay that they're having to get up just to have access to their funds. So, unfortunately, that was a very costly thing for them. In addition to what it was costing the employees, we also had the lost revenue for the company, because obviously in the staffing industry, our revenue is generated from billable hours. So if employees were leaving the job sites early and they were losing hours, we were losing revenue. Not to mention the fact that we really upset our clients when productivity dropped off because of it. So we talked about our local employees. I want to talk about our travelers. And again, these were employees that were working for us in remote areas, oftentimes flying into a job site or driving a long distance to a job site. Because they weren't at home and they were out in hotels on the road, we had to have a way that we could get funds to them securely, most importantly, on time. And the only way that we could really do that and ensure that all that happened and we had the ability to track it was to send these FedEx. And unless we had an extremely strong relationship, Brian, with our client there at that project site, we would, you know, that we could actually ask that client to hand out the checks for our employees when they were handing out checks for their own, which was not the norm. Because obviously we didn't want to inconvenience our clients and ask them to do more work for us. We would send out those FedEx envelopes individually to each employee. And on average, we had about 400 employees that were working on the road any given week. And at $25 for each envelope, I believe that's roughly $10,000 a week, over $500,000 a year, just in the FedEx postage costs alone. Now, in addition to having access to their traditional payroll, with our employees traveling, they always got a per diem. Now, when employees, sometimes this was the case for employees throughout their time on the road, but if nothing else, I would say about 90% of our employees, when they were traveling for us at projects, needed at least an advance in the beginning for the first 2, 3, 4 weeks in order to get them going, since oftentimes they hadn't been working for a couple of weeks and they were a little bit behind in funds. So we would give them an advance, typically $200 to $400. And the way we would do this advance is we would actually fund a card. I guess we kind of called it a pay card, but it was a PIN-only card. So it wasn't what we see oftentimes today used, you know, like an open loop card with a logo on it from Visa or one of the other major card carriers. These were cards that were only PIN cards and could only be used at an ATM. And with the provider that we were using, every ATM that they went to, they had to pay a fee. So the way that we would actually, yes.
If I can ask you there,
sure.
Are those cards what you would call compliant for paying payroll within the different states, or even using for per diem in that respect.
Well, Brian, now that I know what I know, they certainly are not. As we know, employees, when you are paying them funds through payroll, need to be able to access 100% of their pay down to the penny in order to be compliant in all 50 states. Certainly, this card was very far out of compliance because they did have to pay a fee in order to access those funds. And on top of that, being that they could only access funds with a PIN-only card through an ATM, they could only access their money up to a certain dollar amount and could also only access those funds in increments of $20. So that presented another challenge. We would have to each time, you know, if somebody, for example, was asking for $200 for an advance, we would have to actually load on $205. And the reason being is that we wanted that employee to be able to access all $200 that we were giving them as that initial advance. Now that $5 we were charging, you know, we were charging back to them as well when we collected the advance from their paycheck. What got really tricky was that we actually had to instruct the employees each and every time we gave a card that you would have to go to the ATM and you really need to pull out all the funds at one time. Don't do a balance inquiry because that'll charge you a fee. Don't try and take out $100 here and $100 there because each time you do that, you're going to pay a fee. And because we only gave you $5, you know, so you could access all of your funds, if you were to try and do multiple transactions, that $5 is going to be depleted, and you're going to start dipping into your actual advance. So more times than not, we had employees calling us back, even after the instruction, you know, I only have $180-some-odd left on my card, or I took $100 out, and now I can only access 80 of the remaining $96 that I have. What can I do? And we'd have to actually load on more money for fees in order for them to access the remainder, of course, which we were charging back as well. To compound the problems, we had employees that were traveling. They only had access to cash through our PIN-only cards. So this presented a problem with many things. I mentioned that we had a lot of employees that were flying into remote areas. When they landed, they needed a rental car. Without the ability to use a debit card or a credit card to secure that rental car, and rental car companies not accepting cash, we found ourselves actually having to rent the cars for them. My concern, as well as many others, is of course this could potentially open you up to more liability. It also really limited the hotels, Brian, where they could stay. You know, I traveled quite a bit with the companies I work for, and had the opportunity to meet with our field employees, projects all over the country and actually internationally as well. And I can tell you that some of the hotels that these guys were staying at for this very reason were places that I personally wouldn't want to stay, and I certainly wouldn't allow my family to stay at. In addition to everything that we've talked about, a lot of our employees still have families back home, and they have obligations back home. And they have a spouse or possibly a child back home that may have a need such as paying for prescriptions or getting a car repaired or something of that nature. It was always a challenge and a burden on them and a concern in the back of their mind, how do I get money back to my family? So the answer, obviously, was oftentimes them having to leave work again early, again losing, you know, pay, and tracking down the nearest Western Union to where they could wire money home to their spouse or their children in order to meet those obligations. That also created the same concern when it came to paying bills. Now, the last thing that you want when you're on the road, I can only imagine, working 7 days a week and 10 to 12 hours a day, is worrying about leaving work, having to track down a place to get a money order, find an envelope and stamps, getting to a post office, and sending money back to pay for your bills. In addition to everything else, we had a lot of stop payments. As many of us in the staffing industry know, the workforce oftentimes is very transient. So we have challenges in our local markets where we have employees working that are moving from apartment to apartment or house to house, and oftentimes checks are sent out, and then it's after the fact that we find out that they've actually moved, and we actually get the information for a change of address request. In addition to that, with travelers, oftentimes we'd have guys that were traveling on the road, and they'd stay the first week at a hotel, and word of mouth would get around, and they'd find out that there was either a better hotel or a cheaper hotel down the road, and they'd make the move. Of course, we were always the last ones to know. It was always after the check went out, and that always meant that we had to do a manual check, we had to do a stop payment, and we had to FedEx, of course, that check back out again at $25. In addition to the stop payments, another one of the unique challenges in the staffing industry is that we're not always just dependent on internal sources for processing payroll. And what I mean by that, and I'm sure a lot of us here on the phone deal with this, is we are reliant in addition to with our clients, meaning that our employees have time cards, they have to get signed off on, and until those time cards come in to confirm the hours that our employees are reporting to us, we're typically not processing payroll because we're waiting for that final approval. And we often found that the companies I work for, that we would have time coming in, a fair amount of it on Tuesdays, a lot on Wednesdays, and then we'd have a pretty fair amount of it also coming in on Thursdays and even Fridays. And what this did, having different paydays throughout the week and a mad rush towards the end to get payroll completed and out on time, was create stress in the payroll department, create a rush, and when you have those two working against you, unfortunately, you're going to have human error. And when you have errors and a need for correction and pay, that, again, that means a lot of manual checks and a lot of FedEx expenses. So to keep going on this, numerous phone calls, we got them at all hours of the day. We got them at night. We got them on the weekends, holidays. And we heard reasons for just about everything for an employee needing money. Everything from meals to baggage fees and a lot of other interesting things in between. We've talked about the workforce that we have working for us out in the field, those employees that are working with our clients. Where I have worked in the past, in addition to those employees, we've had a very large sales force. In fact, one company I was with, we had over 200 individuals that were in a sales capacity. And because they didn't have a corporate card, what we would do, and all of us would do this, was with our expenses, whether they were client meals, employee appreciation, you know, meals or you know, get-togethers, whatever it may be, we would put together all of our expenses in an expense report, turn it in, and get reimbursement. And what this meant to the company was a lot of manual checks. So I would imagine that this is just another area where we could have saved a lot of time and a lot of money having a true pay card in the payroll department.
Dallas, thank you for outlining the many problems that everybody in our audience faces every single day. And now it's up to us to build a case for how the prepaid WEX Rapid pay card with the Visa logo can counteract those issues. And just to let you know that the market is growing and will expect to grow significantly, I wanted to bring you some information from Visa. And as you can see, market today in 2012 is a $986 billion market related to prepaid, and the payroll card is part of prepaid. And the opportunity continues to grow significantly all the way to 2018. It is also important to see all the different types of users, and they go all the way from the underserved segment all the way to college students and teens, as well as the mass banked. Everybody on this call that has a bank account would be part of the mass banked, and we have many employers that find with split direct deposit that some of their employees that are already banked will choose to have a secondary direct deposit onto the WEX Rapid pay card. The opportunity is sizable and is largely untapped still for payroll cards with less than 5% penetration, but the opportunity is large. And those that still receive a paper check in the, across the country is still large. It is interesting to see that you have a significant amount of the population, almost 75%, or 75 million rather, with 64%, that do in fact have direct deposit. And then the check numbers of employees is about 35 million, roughly 30% of the total population. And of those still receiving a check, 13.7 million do in fact have bank accounts, but they still choose to receive a check. And there are all kinds of reasons for that. Sometimes the employee does not want their employer to know if they have a bank account, or doesn't necessarily trust the banks. And that can be a good reason also for having a prepaid pay card, such as the WEX Rapid Pay Card. So why are prepaid cards a payroll option? Mainly is that it provides the employee with a network-branded prepaid card that can take simple direct deposit with efficiency, security, and flexibility of direct deposit. So it's safety, security, and speed that is provided with this particular option, and it is provided to you today through Tricom Funding on the WEX Rapid Pay Card. Most prepaid cards benefit from broad acceptance because they have that brand that Dallas was speaking about. The WEX Rapid Pay Card is a Visa debit card, and it is a debit card that is accepted anywhere that Visa is accepted all across the world. It also may provide you a point of free cash delivery and employees access for their payroll completely free. In fact, it allows for the employees to have 100% of their pay available to them on payday at zero cost. And Dallas talked about the problems that you all face with cashing a check, especially if it is an out-of-state check, for your employees. The WEX Rapid Pay Card with the Visa logo allows many, many options in the fact that it can be used at anywhere that the card is accepted. Also can be used in the five free ways that are available for your employee to replace the action of cashing a check are going straight to one of the 98,000 Visa member banks, going to any United States Postal Service in order to get a free money order with the WEX Rapid Pay Card and cash it on the spot. They also can have a check that is attached to the card where they can go to any 4,200 Walmart locations across the country, write themselves a check, and get 100% of their cash for free. They call customer service and request a check, and the check can be mailed to them so that they can have access to their pay. They also have the ability to do an ACH transfer to a bank account and maintain their security of their bank account while getting all of their pay over to their bank account completely free. The other component that's important about having a Visa debit card through Tricom Funding and utilizing the WEX Rapid Pay Card is that much of today's economy requires electronic payment. Think about all the things that Dallas described in his problems that are corrected if you have the ability to use a debit card to make the payment, renting cars, shopping online, paying a bill online, all of those things. So the user of a prepaid card today and a pay card today are those employees that are seeking a non-credit payment tool that helps them control their budget and offers them the same fraud and loss protections that you and I enjoy on our debit card every single day. And the other aspect that comes to play for the employees is that they have the ability to have their funds loaded by payroll. Just as direct deposit would happen for you, it happens for them. And it also can be used for things such as reward payments, incentive payments, thank you gifts, or even they can sign up for government benefits, and all government benefits can be delivered onto their own personal WEX Rapid Pay Card themselves. It also helps with the aspect of unclaimed property because this particular account is a virtual bank account that is owned by the employee. And once they stop working for you, all you need to do is simply stop paying them. An additional benefit that is brought to you by having the pay card available is that employees that are parents of college-age students may want to split their direct deposit and have the ability to have a secure, safe, convenient way to get money to their student without their risk of running up debt. These cards cannot be overdrawn. You have no ability to spend beyond the amount that's on the card, so it really, really is safe for the consumer and the cardholder. The cards work just like a traditional debit card with the Visa logo on it, and they are a prepaid card that allows them to shop online anywhere that a regular debit or credit card can be used. You can use it to pay bills, book airline tickets, rent a car, buy dinner. In other words, it provides you with financial dignity. And all these cards allow for consumers to take cash out at ATMs. The WEX Rapid Pay Card is a member of the Allpoint ATM network. There are 44,000 of them all across the country, actually outside of the country as well. And we also provide an additional network called MoneyPass. That's an additional 20,000, so you have all kinds of access points. But interestingly enough, in today's world versus even 2 years ago, the ATM is not as critical as it used to be. In fact, many consumers like the safety, security, and convenience of having a virtual bank account with a WEX Rapid Pay Card because of the Visa logo. The Visa logo allows for the fraud and loss protections of the zero fraud liability that comes with Visa, and it also allows the cards to have immediate access to their funds on payday. So while I'm working on your job site in the morning, I get a text message alert that allows me to know that the funds have been loaded onto my account. And by lunchtime, I'm shopping at the Burger King across the street, ordering my food, and without having to worry about, you know, running out and cashing that check. But most importantly, I'm also able to get cashback rewards because I went to Burger King, and the WEX Rapid Pay Card is actually incentivizing people with cash back onto their card if they take advantage of certain promotional things that are available to them as a cardholder. Prepaid cards help the consumer control their budget because it doesn't have any interest charges. In fact, the only interest that comes along with the WEX Rapid Pay Card is a real benefit. It is a savings account that is free for them to sign up for, and they can gain an interest-bearing savings account that is unique in the marketplace, and they also don't ever have to worry about running into overdraft fees or anything that sounds like an overdraft fee. So who is the user for prepaid cards? Is it you? It very well may be, because the marketplace is changing, and in today's world, prepaid cards such as the WEX Rapid Pay Card offered by Tricom can in fact be a viable alternative to a bank account. And the reason for that is the cost models are changing, and the acceptance of prepaid cards has risen dramatically. You will see that there are new fee structures associated with banking accounts, such as checking accounts. Those of you that have not received a letter from your bank talking about the change in your fee structure probably should check that mail. I'm not very good at checking my mail related to information coming from my bank because I do everything online, but I do know that my fee structures have changed, and now many of the bank accounts, checking accounts, require a minimum balance in order to maintain free checking. So if I have to keep $1,500 a year or more in my bank account, is it really free? Not really. Also, the lowest one that I've heard is $100 in order to maintain free checking. And for most of our cardholders and probably most of your employees, it's impossible for them to maintain a $100 balance. So therefore, they are moved over to something that costs between $10 and $15 a month in order to have that checking account and has the ability to be overdrawn, which can be a real budget buster for those employees. The pay card allows for them to have free bank account without a monthly charge, and if all they want to do is do simple point-of-sale transactions, swiping the card at the point of purchase, oftentimes that can be free as well. There are fewer branch offices also in lower to middle income communities and many times in places where your employees may be working, so getting to their funds becomes a challenge. And one of the things that we help you with at WEX Rapid PayCard is to provide you with outstanding education to your employees so that they understand how to use their card and use it in the most economical fashion. It allows for those employees to understand ways to stay out of business and stay out of trouble, I'm sorry, and to conduct their basic financial business in a fashion that maintains their dignity as well without having to utilize those alternative financial service locations such as the check casher. Let's talk about the estimated annual cost for basic checking versus cash versus general purpose reloadable prepaid cards, which are those cards that are available in Walgreens or any place else such as the check casher, and then pay card. This is a bit of an eye chart, so I made it simple for you so that you can actually read it easier, and that's where we'll go through this particular graph. As you can see, a bank account with even very favorable fees associated with the bank account, and red is typically the most expensive financial tool available to your employees. Here comes cash right behind it. For the basis of cashing your check and getting to cash, it is still an expensive alternative, but most importantly, it doesn't allow you to operate in today's environment in most cases. Then you have the general purpose reloadable card, which is a debit card that they can use to sign up for direct deposit, but it requires acquisition costs by the employee, and the fee structures are not as favorable as PayCard. PayCard averaged out at $83 a year in order to use, and I would tell you that's on the higher end, and that is for somebody that is probably paying at least one or two bills online or taking care of or taking advantage of value-added services that might be offered by the PayCard. You do have the ability, if all you want to do is replace the action of cashing a check, to utilize the WEX Rapid PayCard completely free. And that's why we also go to the factor of sometimes you face, my employees like to cash checks. Well, they have the ability to cash a check with the WEX Rapid PayCard. All they have to do is go to any of the Walmart locations and they can cash that check completely free. Or even better, go to the exact same bank or place that they were cashing their check before, and because it has a Visa logo on that card, they simply walk up to the counter, swipe their card, enter their PIN number, and they get 100% of their cash off of that card for free, and they've replaced the action of cashing a check. If they want to go a step further and have that actual check sent to them, they have the ability to call customer service, and the check can be sent to them for free. Or they can go into that U.S. Postal Service, which there's almost one in every zip code today, and swipe their card. There is a fee for the Postal Service money order, but our system is smart enough to know that it should not be charged for, and they can write that money order for 100% of their pay and cash it right there at the Postal Service for free. The other option that they have is that ACH transaction straight to their bank account, or to sometimes we have folks that use it to pay maybe their landlord or somebody else that they might owe and have that ACH right off their card after every payload for free. In the staffing industry, the potential for pay card is huge because, as we showed in the problem associated with staffing, is you have a high percentage of unbanked employees, and the check distribution problem for your diverse workforce spread out over much of the market that you're covering is significant, and the most expensive way to deliver that payroll is not, as Dallas stated in his problem, which was significant with FedEx. The most expensive way is you. You are the producer that is out there trying to generate revenue for your company. And when you're spending time taking being a courier for paychecks, you're losing potential revenue, and that can be significant. So the staffing industry, the potential for PayCard, again, is huge because you have a high percentage of unbanked employees. You know, most of those employees do not have checking accounts, so therefore they're going to the bank or the check cashing service, and they're spending significant monies. And WEX Rapid Pay Card replaces the action of cashing a check at zero cost to you as the employer and potentially zero cost to the employee if all they're doing is getting cash. And we talked about the five free methods to get 100% of their pay off of the card every time that card is loaded. And it is the most robust methods of anybody in the marketplace with the WEX Rapid Pay Card, so that can be a big savings for your employees. The WEX Rapid Pay Card is, as I said, five free ways, but also let's hand it over to Dallas and get his flavor on the savings that come along by using a pay card as well.
Well, looking at the check distribution we have up here on the screen at $25 each for 400, again, we're talking about a savings of $10,000 a week or $520,000 a year, and that sounds pretty good to me. That's of course added right back onto the bottom line. You know, travelers requiring per diem. We talked about the cost there for them to access their funds. And obviously, if they can go in and access their funds any of those five free ways, we're saving them not only a ton of money, but we're saving them a ton of time. And, you know, of course, as you mentioned, it is simply direct deposit, so it doesn't get any easier than that. There is no change to the process for the payroll department. It's handled exactly like for your weekly payroll, exactly like the direct deposit that you're currently doing for those employees that are receiving it. And because it's a prepaid Visa card, all of those problems that we talked about where the employee could not make a purchase due to a need for electronic or digital payment, they all go away. And let's see, we talked about travelers, requiring help to get money home and paying bills. Brian, as you mentioned, they certainly can pay their bills over the phone or online with the Rapid Pay Card. In addition, with a companion card, they can also do the split direct deposit or a card-to-card transfer to their family members back home to pay for those prescriptions or car repairs or anything else that's needed.
One of the things, yep, Dallas, that I like, that I really like, is the text message alerts. Is that on my particular account, I am signed up for text message alert. It is a free service from WEX. I do have unlimited texting on my phone, so I don't get a charge from my provider as well. But I get a text message alert to my phone notifying me that it's payday. But also, even if I do a card-to-card transfer to my daughter, for example, when she needs money and I'm on the road and I send her some cash to fulfill an obligation she might have at school or a need that she has, she gets an alert letting her know that the $15 that she requested is there immediately. And the card-to-card transfer through our mobile web app is also really, really simple to do and exciting for me as a parent to be able to solve problems with my daughter easily and for her also to have the safety of not losing that cash. So that's a way that I use it. And also, in addition to that, I have bill pay is something that we do oftentimes take advantage of, and many of your cardholders may take advantage of that as well. As Dallas talked about in his example, you have employees that need to pay bills while they're on the road, and this is something that is able to be done off of that mobile app or onto the simple website that cardholder can take advantage of. Where are you allowed to use pay cards? Is there any place that makes it more difficult? There are the states listed here by Visa where you can mandate direct deposit, and the ones below, Florida, Iowa, and Virginia, have particular dates that the employee must be employed after those dates in order to go forward with mandating direct deposit. But with our five free ways for the employee to get their pay, off of their card for free. We are compliant in all 50 states, so you shouldn't have fear about moving forward with the WEX Rapid Pay Card. It can be used in all 50 states. Prepaid card satisfaction is there. That's one of the concerns that many individuals like you that are running a business is, are my employees going to like it? Well, cardholders do like it, and who are they? They aren't just the downtrodden. In fact, many of the cardholders today, 43% are Gen Y. One-third earn more than $45,000 a year. 34% have college degree or higher, and they're very satisfied with the service that they receive, and that is designated here in this particular chart, where you can see that 94% of the users found the cards to be useful in some form or fashion and like it. This also emphasizes the point that I stated earlier. Where are the cards being used? And as you can see, the smallest bar is, in fact, ATM. If I showed you the same graph 3 years ago, it would be reversed to where probably 9% would be at stores and restaurants and 40% would be at ATMs. But today, everybody understands what a debit card is, and now the fact that you can even use a debit card at places like flea markets, it's very, very well accepted and highly utilized by your employees, and it provides them the safety, security, and convenience that they require in today's marketplace, where on a percentage basis, the cost of a pay card to the consumer is only about 1% of their total earnings, which is a very positive thing for everybody involved. So what are the reasons why a card may not achieve your company goals? They are the following. Lack of awareness by you and by your employees. Misconceptions about the pay cards by you and by your employees. Misconceptions about employee receptivity. Most times that's just a preconceived notion by management. And finally, ineffective communication with your employees. So you want to be sure that you select somebody that is going to provide value to your employees and solve problems for your employees. And hopefully we've been able to make that case for you today. But the beauty of many of the cards is they're growing with technology and they're enabling mobile. And you can see in today's world with the WEX Rapid Pay Card, you have the ability for those employees that are on the move in order to utilize real-time text, two-way text messaging for everything from receiving their balance, which is they just simply text in BAL, check their savings account by simply texting in SAV, check out their transactions. They get four listed at a time, I believe it is, and they text in TRANS. And if they want to see more of them, they just simply text more, and you keep going on down the line. But the point is that everything can be accessed by your employee via text message, which is critical because oftentimes some of your employees don't have access to a computer, and you also don't want to have to turn over access to a computer at your workplace. And text messaging is a real advantage. Savings for all is also great. It's no cost. It also allows for some interest-bearing savings, and it is kept in a separate account, so they have to knowingly take money out of their savings and move it over to be spent. The employee gets paid immediately on payday, and they will be notified usually mid-morning of payday via a text message if they signed up for it. And there's also in staffing the possibility of increasing your revenue because the employee is not leaving the job early. And you might say, well, you don't let them leave early. But oftentimes, Dallas has expressed to me that in his history that the employer or their boss felt bad for the employee because they did not have access to their money and would allow them to leave early. And with the pay card, it allows you to tell all of your clients that no one ever needs to leave early because they're all being paid by direct deposit. So in summary, we tried to answer the case for why pay card is a great alternative for you to pay your employees in the staffing industry. We gave you an overview of the unbanked employees, hopefully talked about the employee benefits of pay cards, and finally how we could impact that. And that is the end of our story, and we're open for questions.
Okay, great. Thank you. I've got a couple questions that have come in here, so let me get to those here. So the first one is, can you tell me what's the process of implementing and getting people enrolled on the PayCard system?
Okay, and Shelley, I may need a little bit of your assistance here in case I misspeak regarding the Tricom funding process, but my understanding is all they have to do is contact their particular payroll individual within Tricom. In my case, I usually reference Rick Kirky. In the individual's case, they may have an appointed designated person in order to express some interest in the pay card. The program is completely free, and all we do is get them signed up onto the WEX Rapid Pay Card. It's a very simple agreement. Then we go through a training process where we can show them how to issue those cards. It allows for the employer to simply have a stock of the instant issue WEX Rapid Pay Cards on hand. At the time that they employ an individual, such as me, I'd walk in, apply for my job, you're going to staff me that day. You simply hand me the rapid pay card, pass along the direct deposit information that you knew through our web portal onto the payroll group at Tricom, and I am paid on direct deposit from that point forward. But it's very, very simple. It takes about 20 seconds in order to register a card, and we provide you all the training on the initial basis as well as on an ongoing basis if you have more people that need to be trained on how to enroll a person in a card.
Great. Let's see, another one here. Does the card belong to the employee or does it belong to my staffing company?
The card belongs to an employee. The employee is the owner of the account. And that is important for acceptance of the card, number one. The employee wants to know that it's their account and that they are the only ones that can see it. It also is important for abandoned property or escheatment that you might have to deal with. That goes away because you're paying every employee right onto their own account. Also, if the employee works at multiple jobs, they can use this card in order to be paid by direct deposit anywhere else that they work.
Okay. A few more questions here. So if the card is lost or stolen, how soon to get it replaced? Is it possible to overnight it?
It is possible to overnight it. The employee or the cardholder employee can call customer service and request that. But the best way to get the card is to simply go to your branch office where you'll have a stock of cards. And you just hand them an envelope and tell them to call customer service. Our lost and stolen process is very easy and also is unique in the fact that we have something called card linking. So once that initial account is established and the person is paid to an account, if they get, they can have as many new pieces of plastic as necessary, and as soon as they activate that new card, they will immediately have access to their funds. They can also simply, when they call in to activate that new card, they will cancel the old card, and that protects that old card. And all of our cards are debit cards with a PIN number, so unless you write the PIN number on the card, which they're instructed never, ever to do. Your monies are safe, and the zero fraud liability protects them. There was another question that I saw pop up on the screen, Shelley, that talked about the charge for a transaction at the store. And whenever somebody selects a credit, that is a free transaction for the employee, and they can use the card completely free at a store, because that's one of the methods by which we make money is the swipe fee that's paid to us by Visa whenever the person uses the card. Another question that I got was what happens to any balance left on the card that may not be accessed via the ATM if the balance is too small. First off, there are multiple ways to get your money off of the card all the way to the penny. We told you five. They always have the ability to go into any Visa member bank and get it all the way down to the penny, even if it is 38 cents that they can take it off. They also always have the ability to contact customer service and get us to pay off the balance of that account with a request a check. And there are multiple ways in which they are able to get all the way down to those odd cents off of the card, and they can do that typically for free. So there should never be an instance where they are locked in only to the ATM. That's what makes our card different than many of the others.
I don't know if you saw this other one here, Brian. It said, I don't understand how you receive all paycheck from an ATM since some ATMs have a limit.
Correct. And you're talking about limits such as an ATM might have a $75 limit, might have a $250 limit, might have even a $500 limit. In our case, again, it's the only time that people feel like they're limited is when they stay locked onto the ATM. The ATM is not the main way in which people utilize our card. In fact, it's today, as I showed in that one graphic, utilized about 9% of the time. Most of the time, folks are swiping the card the way you and I do in order to use it as their virtual bank account. But if they simply want to replace the action of cashing a check, they will go to one of those five free methods to get all of their money off of the card. And if you'll notice, in those five free methods, not one of them was the ATM. It was going to any Visa member bank, which there are 98,000 of them all across the country, swipe their card at the counter and ask the teller to give them all of their money. And at that point, they can get in excess of multiple thousands of dollars and odd cents back from the teller. It also is the ability to go to a U.S. Postal Service. It also is the ability to do a write themselves a check and go to Walmart, and the ability to get a check from our customer service if they wanted, or ACH to a bank account.
Okay, it looks like I've got one more question here for you, Brian. For individuals that don't have a cell phone, is there another way to alert them when funds are available to use?
Dallas, do you want to handle that, or do you want me to?
Sure. Well, you know, there are several different ways that they can check the funds on the card, you know, their balance, their transaction history, really all of the transactions, and utilize the same functionality that all of us enjoy with our bank, traditional bank accounts. If they don't have a cell phone, so they aren't able to receive the text messages, which are an extremely valuable tool, and we actually find that most people today not only have cell phones, but also, you know, for the most part, have smartphones, which can take advantage of our mobile smartphone app. If they don't have that phone, then what they can do is they can call customer service. Customer service is always free, and they're always available 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. And again, there's never a charge for them calling customer service. And they'll always have somebody.
Can they use a payphone, Dallas?
Of course. It's a toll-free number. You're talking about calling customer service, Brian?
Yes, sir.
Of course, of course. And if they have access to a computer, you know, whether it's at work or back at home or at a friend's or a library, they can also access all of their account information, you know, via the cardholder portal.
Okay, I've got another question here. Is there an option to deposit funds into the card coming from the card owner, not coming from the ER or government agency?
I will answer that. At this point in time, there is not, due to anti-money laundering or rules associated with that in the Patriot Act. There will be here in the near future the ability to add some funds in the form of check capture, and we expect that to be launched here in the next 6 months, which will allow, say, an individual who has maybe a check for a birthday gift, or even if you had somebody else or even yourself, that you were able to write a check where you could go ahead and capture that check with a smartphone and load the funds on in that fashion. There is one other option. I'm sorry, I misspoke. They can go and take advantage of Green Dot or Western Union money loading so that they can load funds onto the card in that fashion as well. If they are near a location that is a Green Dot loading location or a Western Union loading location. Dallas, did I get everything covered there?
You sure did.
All right. Oh, I think I have one more question here. When is there a fee charged and how much? So give some examples of when a fee would be charged, a transaction where a fee would be charged.
Okay, a transaction where a fee may be charged would be, let's say I was paid yesterday. I went to the Allpoint ATM yesterday that is located in the Target lobby, so in a lobby of a Target store, and I was paid yesterday $256. Yesterday when I went to that ATM, I took out $100. Today when I go to that ATM, I would maybe take out another $100. I will encounter a fee at that time, and honestly, I can't remember the fee structure that Tricom has. Shelley, you would be able to tell them that by pulling the fee structure for we give beneficial fee to Tricom. So if somebody wants to follow up with me specifically after the call, I can tell you exactly what that fee would be. We do have the ability to show in a cardholder how they can minimize those fees, and that's why it is more economical than a traditional checking account. And I can give more clarity to that question after this call if I can pull the Tricom fee structure.
And I've got both Brian and Dallas's contact information up here. I've got your email addresses, so I'm assuming that's probably the best way to reach either of you. And I think that's all of the questions. So with that, I think we'll wrap everything up. I'd like to thank our participants in today's webinar, as well as Brian and Dallas, for sharing their knowledge and expertise on pay cards. The recording of the webinar will be available on our website at tricom.com/resources. If you have any questions or you would like a copy of today's PowerPoint presentation or the recording, feel free to contact Brian, Dallas, or me. Thank you all very much again for participating in today's webinar, and watch for information on our next webinar session in May. So thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye now.